the Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. panel. This one's going to be a little different for us. This is our chance to say thank you to all of you for over 100 episodes. This is our chance to be able to talk about past seasons, new seasons.
And then,
that are behind the scenes in New York at Marvel, Dan Buckley, Joe Psy, Alan Fine, at Marvel Television in LA, Jim Corey, Megan Thomas Bradner, Kareem, Wendy Wilmeade, and Emmy nominated Jeffrey Paul. Our friends at ABC Studios, Patrick Moran, Heather Condon, and Dave Ong, and the studio that within the network that we hope hears that we want more. Incredibly supportive, Jenny Dungy, Vicki Hummer, Joe DeSante, Andy Kubitz, and Sarah. Thank you all so much. And there are behind the scenes of the marketing and PR people who put together this and put together everything that we do. Thank you so much to all of them. Now, here comes the fun part. They get to bring out all the folks you really want to see. And I will start that out with my good friend and who's been with us from day one, and that is Mr. Jeff Bell, executive producer. They've been on the show so long that they actually had a kid. They are our co-creators and our showrunners. They are Jed Whedon and Marissa Tanscher.
Washington right now.
did do was he made a little video. I think there's a microphone there, and I don't know if there's other microphones anywhere else. It certainly makes my life easier if it's only in one place. We got time, so we'll take questions.
Hi, my name's Andrew, and
hi, Andrew.
I'm Asian American, and I just wanted to thank Jeff and Beth and Mo and Jen for putting on a show that has not one but two API leads, and that's something that we'll have to show us.
Yeah, no. And I said, can I guess? And then I said, goofy enough looking to play D.
If you guys can't tell, our fun thing right now is just making fun of Jeff. It's just gonna keep going. It'll be happening throughout this panel. So if you guys want to join him.
So yeah, if anyone wants to join in, then it's perfectly okay.
It's out of club though, nothing actually mean.
Have you just looked
at him? No, he is just to be at the house. So happy to be here.
Let me ask you, Jeff, seriously, what's it like right now to be at a con in front of a bunch of people who make a lot of noise? Oh my God. It's going so well. It's crazy because I've never, this is my first con of any kind. And to see the amount of love for the show and everybody, you know, because it's such a diverse cast and because it's such a smart show, and to see that it really has a real effect on people. I've never been a part of something that has had this big of an effect on people, so it's really special to be a part of it. It's not as special to be the moving target of the show.
Bad.
I mean, it's look at all these people making fun of me.
I'm pretty hungry, so
I'm
gonna get you something while I'm talking.
Are you all just talking about going to the bathroom? It seems like I started talking, and everyone was like, "All right, are you good? Should we just get out of here?" I love you, guys. Please don't fire me.
Later on, whether it's from the special effects or whether it's from the incredible acting of anybody other than Jeff Bell. Is there anything that you think of where you go, that was cool, that was unexpected?
I would say we've done a couple things. We always try and scare ourselves a little bit. And so Ghost Rider was scary because that could go wrong. And the future with Kree wearing mind makeup could go wrong. But no, I think all the people behind the scenes have put together amazing things. We jumped off that cliff and made sure that we landed safely. So I'm very, very happy with that.
Cool. Our next question.
First of all, thank you for making it to 100 episodes. I've been there since the first day you premiered at Comic-Con a few years ago.
Thank you so much.
I've been every time the show ever since. My question is for the showrunners. What's the backstory of getting Zima on this season? Because just crazy, man.
You know, we were talking about what it would be like to come from that time and be dropped on this earth, and what would he first do? You know, Deke's a very particular kind of guy. He built a bar, a virtual bar, and so we figured that he would probably be disappointed in the taste of beer. So the next logical choice is Zima, I think. It's the least manly thing he could drink. We also knew, I don't know if you can tell from the way we treat him, Jeff Ward is very funny, and we knew that cutting him loose in a bar with some Zima would end up with gold, so we figured, let's just put those two things together and just see, mix them together, just see what happens, you know?
Yeah, Jeff's doing all the funny work, the Zima is just the extra, you know, added bonus.
It's like the exclamation point.
Yeah.
That's a bit nice, but that's...
Zima. See? Oh, okay, great. And next question.
My question is for Chloe. After milestone.
Thank you.
Like, what sort of future do you see for yourself as Di or Daisy Johnson?
I kind of hope that he's a boyfriend who doesn't try to kill her or die, or isn't a Nazi. And if we go another season, I would love to just kind of see her find somebody to love. I don't know. And I think that's it. I just want her to like Netflix and chill. Like, I just really want an episode where we all just hang out and eat food,
drink for
like, just eat. You know, selfishly. That's what I.
Be careful what you wish for.
Yeah,
that's true. I agree. Yeah.
You haven't read the finale yet.
I'm just eating the whole time. No, honestly, we've been through so much. They're so incredible with the writing, and they've taken us on such a crazy journey, and I look forward to what they're going to, you know, think of next, because it's always such a surprise, and it's so heartfelt and filled with, I don't know, yeah, I want her to have a boyfriend.
Next question.
My name is Nicholas Bloom. First of all, congratulations to you guys for making 100 episodes, 5 seasons. The show is amazing.
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
My favorite character is Agent May because she's badass. My question is for you. What was the most challenging scene you did during season 3?
She's gonna season 3. Do you remember what happened in season 3?
That's when Elizabeth went to the Blue Planet. You weren't in that episode.
No, I wasn't in that episode. But was that the episode? You're Elfie.
Lash.
Yeah, it was Lash. That true one. Yes, thank you. I think, you know, the wonderful thing was I got to work with Blair Underwood as my husband, Andrew. Sorry to the Philippa fans.
I know, what's going on with my hair?
it looks beautiful.
That's great. Yeah.
Again, though, you know, that wasn't a relationship that worked out well, unfortunately. But, yeah, it was very tough because it sort of made you realize what happened to Agent May and why she became who she was because of Bob Ray. But, yeah.
So, thank you for your question.
Thank you.
Marissa, it seems like when either one of these young ladies here get in a relationship, it ends terribly. Should we be concerned at all about Mac and Yo-Yo? The other folks that are perhaps emotionally involved in the show?
I mean, having a relationship in this line of work, it's complicated. You know, they're always up against the end of the world, and you gotta squeeze them in intimacy moments, like...
Are you
talking
about us now?
I mean, I'm looking...
I do all the relationships in badly, Marissa.
From my past, I don't know. Nothing, it has nothing to do with my current situation at all. At all. Jeff, lighten the mood here.
No, we're gonna have that out right here. We're Fitzsimmons. We're good.
Yeah, they are Fitzsimmons for sure.
Without all the like planetary drama. Yeah.
Yes, I mean.
Their relationship goals, for real. I mean, to work with each other every day, and you know, and then to have a beautiful child, Benny, and then
Benny's
in first Comic Con.
I don't see them, but they're here somewhere. Benny, Sue, and Michelle.
Yeah, it's incredible what they do as a duo.
So the real life fits in.
I just stand them. What's standing?
Bummer fan. Stan? Stalker fan? That's creepy.
Next question, before we actually have to explain that. Anybody that you'd like a little more screen time with?
Chad.
You guys, I have to work on FaceTime. You guys, stay out of here. You want to say something, Kate? I can put you to the microphone.
And I was wondering if there's any chance we could see something that we haven't seen before.
You mean like a clip? I don't know. Guys, did you bring anything? I mean, we brought Deke. That was the deal. Let's not bring Deke, and I said, yeah, let's not bring Deke and show footage of something. And so we brought Deke. So
I'm sorry.
But we also brought footage.
We did.
Yeah.
And I can see you, and so can the Agent Shield that are walking around with their night vision goggles. Ladies and gentlemen, the producers, writers, and the stars of Marvel's Agent Shield. Before you guys stand up, and they can take your picture. Thank you all for a wonderful panel and a way for us to be able to say thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it once again for the great